Well, it's been about 2 months since my last upload here on the Juneferno channel, and while I do refrain from getting into personal topics here, I do have to admit that I've been dealing with a bit of a tragedy recently, called the modern education system. Nonetheless, what better way to take a break from all the programming and 3D models than to learn a Gaem engine? Let's talk about Unity. Before Gaem engines, video games were typically developed from the bottom up, all the way from communicating with the display hardware to the actual game logic. However, as both hardware and video games became more and more advanced, video games started having more and more similar components, such as gravity or collisions, or just drawing things on a screen. Developing games pixel by pixel is a lot of work, and as video games shifted to larger memory home consoles rather than arcade machines that have constantly changing hardware, there was very little reason for why all the low-level programming had to be redone for every single game. And so it was only a matter of time before frameworks were developed to make the process a lot less painful. A Gaem engine is a software framework that provides the same core functionality to many different games. One of the earliest notable Gaem engines was Nintendo's in-house side-scrolling Gaem engine, made for Excitebike for the NES, and then later on reused for Super Mario Bros. Note how both of them smoothly scroll between different speeds. By the time first-person shooter games such as Doom and Quake came out in the 90s, the whole process of creating games, especially 3D ones, had become exceedingly complicated. And as the saying goes, why do it when you can simply not? And so rather than creating more first-person shooters from the bottom up, other developers licensed the core parts of the software that made the game a first-person shooter game, and then just added their own content on top of it to make a new game. And thus, commercial game engines rose in popularity. As time grew on, many new engines were developed, while old engines added new features to handle more parts of different games. A game developed on the current version of Unreal Engine rarely has any resemblance to the original 1998 Unreal first-person shooter. Nowadays, the game engines available to the public are a wide array of software, which can be as general or specific to the type of game as you want. This ranges from you can only display graphics to you can only make visual novels about high school anime characters. Regardless, on the topic of game engines, perhaps the one that comes to people's minds first and foremost, especially amongst indie developers and people who can read the title, is Unity Game Engine. Unity Game Engine is a cross-platform general-purpose game engine that some people say makes game development easy. However, it also makes terrible game development easy, and so game development is actually hard again. Nonetheless, being such a widespread game engine, even the most casual of game developers has probably at some point in time installed Unity, opened it, closed it, and then never touched it again. Well, now that we know what a game engine is and what Unity is, it should only be a short matter of time before we're making well-polished games, yeah? Let's open Unity. Once we open an empty 3D project in Unity, we can see a drag-and-drop interface with the renderer already clearly implemented. As Unity is a general-purpose game engine, it generalizes everything by representing everything as an object, as general things tend to be represented by. More specifically, everything is represented by something called a game object. This is because they are all objects that are in a game. Each game object is a combination of its components. Every game object, for example, has the transform component, which tells the renderer the position, rotation, and scale of the object in a scene. These components are what define the game object. A camera, for example, is a game object with a camera component. A light is a game object with a light component. Using these predefined components, one can set many common properties onto their game object, including things like physics, effects, audio, etc. For more custom behavior, you can also add scripts in C#. If you're unfamiliar with C#, imagine Java. So how about 3D models? How would you represent a 3D object with components? The structure of a 3D object is defined by its mesh, which is just a set of vertices in a certain order that maps out the edges of the model. And so a 3D object game object needs some type of mesh renderer component to render the mesh. Now usually when demonstrating 3D models in Unity, we use something useless, such as a cube or a beam. I will be using Shinji from Evangelion. Having just a static 3D object is fine, but what's a game without some cool animations? And so we can use a tool like Blender to rig our Shinji with some bones. A bone is an invisible object that attaches to a segment of the mesh, just like real bones. That way, if we want to animate that segment, we simply just have to move the bone and the vertices will move along with it. Once we've rigged our armature of bones, we can make an animation by opening the animation tab and then closing the animation tab and going to mixamo.com to steal this joke. From there, we can animate our rigged model by taking our animation file and putting it into an asset called the Animator Controller, which we can then attach to an animator component on our object. Finally, simply hit play, and congratulations, you've achieved... Ultimately, all of that was just a simplification of just one feature on Unity Game Engine, and to be quite honest, it's probably all I'm qualified to talk about anyway. However, there is a sentiment amongst a select group of programmers who believe that using a game engine like Unity is, in a sense, not real programming, perhaps due to its simplicity or its drag-and-drop interface. My opinion is that Unity is just another tool, and like all game engines, was designed to make things easier. Even though it's simpler to use, a good or bad game still depends on the developer. There are plenty of poorly designed games made with Unity, but there's also bad piggies. Of course, there are plenty of reasons for why you would want to use a different game engine or even make your own. But the idea that using Unity somehow invalidates the programming is a bit absurd and impractical. Anyway, that's all I had to say about it. How do I usually end these videos?